So I've come back to my two-way and intermediate wiring diagram because I was asked a question. If, for instance, this last switch, I wanted to continue on to another switch. In this video, and if you haven't seen it already, I recommend you check it out on the wiring diagram of intermediate switching. So in other words, we've got two-way and intermediate switching. I said you can have as many intermediate switches as you want. So within this section, what people think it is, as long as at each end, there is a two-way switch. So here we go, this is our two-way switch. Remember, common L1 and L2 or numbered L1, L2, L3, etc. But it's that layout for a two-way switch. And remember, it's only got one switch on the front, so it's a one gang. So I said we must have those at either end with as many intermediate switches as we like. This being a one gang, as we turn it over, we've got the four terminals making this an intermediate switch. And that's what we've got on the wiring diagram. And I was asked the question, what if I wanted to go beyond this one with another switch? When I said you can have as many intermediate switches in the center with two-way switches at the end. It's actually easier than you think in order to do that wiring. So what we're going to do is take this switch out and we're going to add one beyond it. So we get four switches, but not putting it in here, which I said in the video, you can have as many intermediate switches as you like. So if I just pull the drawing back, we're going to change this switch and wire on from this switch. So if I bring it in, I'm going to bring in my drawing here, like so. So I've got an intermediate switch and a two-way switch. So all that's going to happen is the two-way switch on the wall is going to be taken off. And you're going to introduce at this point here the intermediate switch. And then the next switch becomes the new one, becomes the two-way. It's a lot easier than it sounds. So let's just bring the drawing across. Okay, so if I sit that on top of there, what I've done now is, just move it into the center for you. What I've got there is I've gone two-way, intermediate, taken off the two-way switch, introduced an intermediate switch, allowing you to wire another new switching point. So if I stick that down, and we'll introduce then the actual wires and conductors themselves. So let's stick that into position. Make it a little bit easier for me. So the two-way switch is taken off. Two-way switch is taken off the wall and we introduce an intermediate switch. That's all we're going to do. So the cabling system stays the same. So we go there to there, like so. And what we've got now is still got this three-core cable. So we've got this three-core and CPC cable that would have gone into our two-way switch. It's now still in the box, but obviously that switch has been changed. Been changed over to an intermediate switch. And we'll need to wire from this point to our new position, making it the fourth switch in the circuit. And as we said before, each end, we should have a two-way switch. So we've got a two-way switch here, and we'll have a two-way switch down here. So this cable remains the same, but our connections become different now because it's an intermediate switch. And we'll add a cable from this position to our new position, which is our fourth switch, which is the two-way switch. So what I expect to happen is the switch that was here originally that was taken off, we've just moved it into this position and we've introduced an intermediate switch here. So that's what we get. So we go intermediate switch, two-way switch. So the three-core cable, let's make those connections. So it would go in here as before, into the box to make our CPC connection of our three-core. So our three-core cable being our CPC is connected back into either the back of the box or into the front of the switch if it was metal, etc. We've got plastic boxes at college, so this would be secured in the back of the box and not anywhere onto the actual plastic frame. We've still got the three-core, so we bring the brown down. The brown now goes into intermediate switch. Remember, on an intermediate switch, we are either in the top two terminals or the bottom two terminals. So this three-core coming down, I'm effectively putting into the top two terminals. So the brown one goes in here. We've got a grey conductor, which again will need to be identified with brown sleeving. Remember, as it's a switching line conductor, we'll have to oversleeve our grey conductor and our black conductor in order to identify them as switching lines. So we'll introduce, well, it's probably still on the cable, isn't it? Our brown sleeving. And now we've got another connection, haven't we? Because we know an intermediate switch has our four connecting points. The black, which is our common in our two-way circuit, the common one comes and passes through our intermediate switch. It isn't connected in any of the terminals. It passes through. And I've drawn a picture there of an old-fashioned 5-amp connector block here. It could be a red through crimp, which I've shown in a previous presentation. It could be one of these style ones from Ideal Industries as a connector, or one of these WAGO connectors. Sometimes, if you're saying it correctly, it's actually VARGO, but we call them WAGOs, don't we? So that there is a connecting point, not within the switch itself. We make that connection as we did in our previous intermediate switch. So our black comes in and passes obviously out in a moment. Remember, we must put brown sleeving on that. So that was the three core cable that we had originally that was in the switch under here, which was two-way, which is now an intermediate switch. We now wire into our fourth switch, and that's where we're ending it. So we know the last switch and first switch in two-way and intermediate needs to be a two-way switch. So we've got a two-way switch down here, like so. So we've got our two-way switch, common L1 and L2, or variants on that. It might be L1, L2, L3, etc. But we've got that arrangement. So either way around, one on its own is common, L1 and L2, etc. So our common terminal. So we've got to make sure we get the right cable color into common. And of our three core ones that we use, I use black as common, and I use my gray and my brown as my L1 and L2. And obviously got a CPC. So a three core would be wired from this old position to our new position in order that we get an extra switch added. So let's put the CPC in first. So if I take my CPC down to link those together, we always like to strike it with a little bit of green and yellow. So let's put the yellow on as well, making that my CPC. My black of my three core connects my terminal block in here to my common. And again, we must make sure we identify it with brown sleeving, like so. And it just leaves us now the gray and the brown of our three core in order to connect into our two-way switch. It doesn't matter which one of these two terminals it goes in, but for ease of drawing, I will come out of this one down to here with the brown and this one down here with the gray. So let's bring our brown of our three core down into L1 or L2. It doesn't matter which of the two terminals that is. So it wouldn't matter which one of those two we chose as long as it wasn't common. And then we bring down our gray, like so. Let's make sure we put our brown sleeving on. This end here of the three core will need brown sleeving on the black, as well as the gray, as well as this gray here. So that was simply all we had to do. So let's pull it round slightly so hopefully we can see the switching arrangement. Can we see the full switching arrangement just there? Okay, so we've got two-way switch, intermediate switch. In our original drawing, this was actually a two-way switch. I was asked how I could put a fourth switch on the end. We now go two-way, intermediate, use the same cable that was there before, swap the switch that was a two-way for an intermediate, add a new three-core cable into circuit, make the connections at the end, making that our two-way. So hopefully that answers the question, how can I add a switch on the end of a circuit that was two-wayed and intermediate originally? I've now added two intermediate switches and moved down my two-way switch. So that was the question that I was asked. So as always, I hope this video has been some help.